we all know marriage is really tough because you have to deal with feelings and lawyers. John Gottman has been researching couples for years and he can predict a divorce with 91% accuracy. So he is really good at what he does. He has come up with four things that are really predictive of divorce. He calls them horsemen. These are small things that if you have it in your relationship, you should watch out because it may end up in divorce. The first horseman is criticism. It's a way of complaining that suggests your partner's personality is defective. Complaining is okay, as long as I talk about myself, what I feel, and what I need. Disaster starts when we try to make it a symptom of our partner's defect. For example, John and Mary are having a conversation and Mary keeps talking about herself and that annoys John. So he responds with saying, "You talked about yourself all through dinner. You never asked anything about my day. And that hurt my feelings. I really needed you to ask about my day." He's talking about himself, what he feels and what he needs. But what if he instead said something like, "You know, you talked about yourself all through dinner. You never asked about my day. What's wrong with you?" Now, John is criticizing Mary and she's going to feel attacked. And this brings us to the second horseman, and that is defensiveness. There are two ways of becoming defensive. The first way is to respond to a complaint with another complaint. And the second way is to act like an innocent victim. Like winning, Mary says,
"I cared about you. I really did. I was interested in your day."
The solution here is very simple. Instead of getting defensive, you accept the responsibility even for a small part of the problem. For example, after John says to Mary, "You never asked about my day," Mary can say,
"God, good point. I was really stressed out. You are right. How was your day?"
The third horseman is the best predictor of divorce, and that is disrespect and contempt. Contempt is a little bit different than criticism. In contempt, you feel superior to your partner. You are talking down to them, like you feel cleaner, more punctual, or smarter than your partner. Then you are going to talk down to them. You may even start calling your partner names or directly insulting them. For example, John says, "What a jerk, you always talk about yourself." Now he may like Mary to respond with,
"John, that is brilliant. Thank you for pointing out all the ways that I am failing as a human. Can we have lunch next week so you can tell me more?"
But people usually don't respond that way. In fact, they really get hurt, and that's why contempt is the single best predictor of divorce. Now, the opposite of disrespect is not doing nothing. It is respect and being proud of people we love. You can do this by saying thank you even for various small things that your partner is doing. Like, "Thank you for picking up the laundry," or "I really enjoyed the conversation at dinner." You start creating a very different habit of mind where instead of creating an environment to criticize, to make yourself superior, you scan the environment for things that you can praise and appreciate. The fourth horseman is stonewalling. This is emotional withdrawal from conflict. Usually when someone listening to a person talking, they give a lot of signals to show that they are following, like eye contact or nodding their head. But the stonewaller does nothing, and that pisses off the speaker. They think that they are not getting through, so they just intensify their effort to have an impact. These are four horsemen of apocalypse, and John Gottman has proved that you can use them to predict with high accuracy what's going to happen to a relationship. They are criticism, defensiveness, contempt and disrespect, and finally stonewalling. These are in fact a recipe for failure. If you have any of these in your relationship and you want your relationship to last, you better start working on them as soon as possible. And if you are still single, the way taxes are, you might as well marry for love. If you learned something new, don't forget to like the video and subscribe for more book summaries like this in the future. See you in the next video.